once again in the second rak'ah. So please follow carefully.
Allahu Akbar.
Remember, we said raising the hands is a sunnah while going for ruku' and while rising up from ruku'. So now we have three positions, and remains with us one more position that the companions of the Prophet ﷺ have seen the Prophet ﷺ raising his hands while he is going to the third rak'ah after finishing the middle tashahud. Same adhkar of ruku'ah, Subhana Rabbiya al-Azim, three times or more, minimum once, Subuhun Quddusur Rabbul Malaikati wa Ruh, and so forth. Do not recite Quran, nor make dua or supplications while in a state of ruku'ah. Rather, now we're ready to say, Sami'a Allahu liman hamida.
سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ رَبَّنَا لَكَ الْحَمْدُ
Or, رَبَّنَا لَكَ الْحَمْدُ حَمْدًا كَثِيرًا طَيِّبًا مُبَارَكًا فِيهِ As well as other supplications which we discussed before. And now once again going for sujood.
اللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ
And without any further delay, sitting up once again.
Allahu Akbar.
And going for sujood the second time.
Allahu Akbar.
And now we're ready to sit for the middle tashahud and listen to the recitation of At-Tahiyyat.
At-Tahiyyatu Lillah. والصلوات والطيبات السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله
Well, up to there is the middle of التشهد. There are some other scholars who stated that the person in the middle tashahud still also have to recite the entire tashahud. So anyway, let's listen to the rest of the recitation of at-tashahud, which is known as As-Salatu al-Ibrahimiyya.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد
By that we finished the illustration of two rak'ahs. Whether it's more than two rak'ahs prior or just two rak'ahs prior such as Salatul Fajr or any voluntary prayer, sunnah, taslim, and so forth. Now, anyway, whenever the musalli is sitting, even between the two sujoods, he would place both hands on both sides, so that the right palm would be placed on the right thigh, and the left palm would be placed on the left thigh. And sometimes the Prophet ﷺ would stretch out his fingers to grab hold of his knees, and that's permissible as well. But if you are in the state of tashahud, the companions narrated a couple of ahadith about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam describing how he would do with his index finger. One hadith which is narrated by Wa'il ibn Hujr, may Allah be pleased with him, he said that he witnessed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam shaking his finger while he was supplicating. And the entire tashahud is all about supplication. So accordingly, the scholars understood from that the musalli is recommended to shake his finger while reciting at tashahud. There is another hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would make number 53 by his fingers, and that's by holding the middle finger with the thumb, then pointing with the index finger towards the qibla. Then He would just keep pointing the finger towards the Qibla as long as he's reciting at-tashahud. As we said before, this is just one of the forms of the prayer, and it should not affect by any means the validity of the salah. As long as the musalli would take care of the arkan, the wajibat, and so forth. The next thing we're going to talk about, what's after the middle tashahud. The sheikh is going to rise up to the third rak'ah, and we're going to learn a very important sunnah that the Prophet ﷺ used to do, which is making takbir and raising the hands along with the takbir. So the sheikh would demonstrate.
Allahu Akbar.
By that we have seen this is the fourth position where the Prophet ﷺ was witnessed by many of the companions while raising the hands while making takbir. The very first takbir, takbirul ihram. The second, for each rak'ah while going for ruku'ah. The third, each rak'ah while rising up from ruku'ah. And the third, after the middle tashahud, upon going to the third rak'ah. This is the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whatever we discussed in the first and the second rak'ah is applicable in the third, if it is Uli Maghrib, or the third and the fourth, if it is one of the four rak'ah's prayers. Except, in the third and the fourth rak'ah, the musalli does not have to recite anything after Surah Al-Fatiha of any of the verses of the Qur'an. But he would make ruku' normally, make sujood normally, and of course, would make sure that he would achieve tranquility in each move, because tranquility is a requirement in the salah. Some of the scholars considered At-Tuma'nina is one of the conditions of the validity of the salah. Now, I think it is very important to compare between the sitting of the middle tashahud and the last tashahud. The middle tashahud, like any sitting between two sajdas, between two prostrations, where the musalli would make his left foot like a cushion beneath his bottom and would sit up his right foot with the toes pointed towards the Qibla. This sitting is known as al-iftirash in Arabic language. While in the last tashahud, there is another sitting which is known as at-tawarruk. You see the changes that all of a sudden that the left shin and the left foot would go all the way beneath the right shin. And the musalli would completely rest on the left side of his bottom. This sitting is known as at-tawarruk, and the musalli would sit this way, this position, in the last tashahud. This is also one of the traditions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam while praying. And of course, notice the finger pointing towards the Qibla as long as the person is reciting at-tashahud or at-tahiyyat. Of course, in the last tashahud,